From wildly shocking death scenes to context-shifting reveals, devious sleights of hand and everything in between, these twists got everyone talking and left them unable to stop. If you claim you saw these twists coming, well, you're probably lying. So with that in mind then, I'm Ellie with What Culture, and here are 10 of the best TV show twists you never saw coming. Number 10. Trinity kills Rita in Dexter. It's generally accepted that Dexter began its brutal decline in quality following the season 4 finale, which ended with such a game-changing shocker of a twist that the writers seemingly struggled to know where to go next. Season 4 saw serial killer Dexter face off against the vicious psychotic Arthur Mitchell, aka the Trinity Killer, which culminated in Dex catching and killing him in the finale. Dex then decides he's going to stop killing in order to truly settle down with his wife Rita and son Harrison, but upon returning home discovers that Arthur murdered Rita before Dex caught him, leaving her bloodied corpse in the bathtub. Worse still, Harrison is sitting in the bathroom in a pool of his mother's blood, just as Dexter did with his own mother as a child. As twists go, this was as poetic as it was shocking, completely upending the series' formula in a totally fascinating and unexpected way, even if it also inadvertently signalled the series' downfall, until it sort of rebounded with the recent Dexter New Blood, at least. Number 9. The flashback is actually a flash forward in Lost. Lost's series finale may have left the fanbase massively divided, but almost everyone will agree with just how brilliantly it pulled off arguably its most inspired sleight of hand at the end of its third season. Season 3's finale, Through the Looking Glass, features a number of apparent flashbacks, as is usual for the series, depicting Jack as a depressed suicidal alcoholic. However, the episode ends with one final flashback where his fellow island survivor Kate shows up. This mind-melting twist confirms that these flashbacks have actually been flash-forwards, taking place after they both manage to leave the island. Jack implores Kate that they need to return to the island, which Kate unsurprisingly disagrees with. Just as mainstream interest in the show was beginning to decline, this bombshell of a twist reeled a lot of waning fans back in, and though what followed proved to be a hugely mixed bag, dropping such a tectonic twist midway through the show's run was nothing if not bold. Number 8. Ned Stark gets beheaded in Game of Thrones. The first of Game of Thrones' many big twists gets an asterisk next to it because, of course, book readers knew precisely what was coming. But given that Thrones was hardly the phenomenon in 2011 that it is today, general audiences were a lot less likely to foresee the fate awaiting Ned Stark. Marketing for the show's first season generally focused on Ned as its protagonist, so for him to be beheaded at the order of King Joffrey Baratheon in the show's 9th episode was practically unthinkable. Director Alan Taylor does a fantastic job toying with the audience too, making them believe that Ned will get a last-minute reprieve, only for a remorseless Joffrey to go ahead with the savage execution anyway. In terms of pure shock value, you can argue that the Red Wedding outdid it, but Ned's death was the moment that confirmed to viewers that this wasn't just another fantasy show and that nobody was safe. Number 7. Walt poisoned Brock in Breaking Bad. Breaking Bad never got one over on fans better than at the very end of its 4th season, when Brock, the son of Jesse's girlfriend Andrea, gets poisoned. Initially, Jesse believes that Walt poisoned Brock, but Walt manages to convince him that meth kingpin Gus Fring was actually the one responsible. In the season finale, Jesse learns that Brock actually fell ill due to eating toxic berries from a plant called Lily of the Valley, seemingly getting Walt entirely off the hook. However, the season's last scene shows the Lily of the Valley plant in Walt's backyard, revealing that he did indeed poison Brock and had concocted this entire scheme to manipulate Jesse into helping him kill Gus. Walt may have been lost in the moral wilderness long before this act, but poisoning a child in order to win was pretty much the last straw for many fans, the turning point at which Walt was truly, unequivocally beyond redemption. Leaving fans to meditate on this revelation for the better part of a year was as ingenious as it was cruel. Number 6. Dr. Cox is at Ben's funeral in Scrubs. Though Scrubs did a generally fantastic job of melding the silly with the heartfelt, nobody was prepared for the sucker punch that was Ben Sullivan's death in the season 3 episode My Screw Up. Ben was Dr. Cox's brother-in-law, who made his third and final appearance on the show in this episode. Ben was previously diagnosed with leukemia, which by this point had apparently gone into remission. Cox spends much of the episode agonizing over a patient's death he thinks he could have prevented, and when he heads to his son's birthday party at the end, JD asks him, "Where do you think we are?" At this point, we see that they're actually in a cemetery attending Ben's funeral. Ben was the patient who died earlier on, and Dr. Cox had merely been imagining Ben's presence in his head ever since. Twists like this are tough to pull off without feeling hokey or manipulative in a post-Sixth Sense world. But thanks to the clever storytelling and John C. McGinley's phenomenal performance, it's a total baller. Number 5. Vic kills Terry Crowley in The Shield. Generally speaking, TV shows wait a good while before walloping audiences with a twist, because they tend to be far more effective when they've been built up over the course of an entire season, or perhaps multiple seasons. Yet FX's gritty cop drama The Shield wasted no time at all by shocking viewers with a brilliantly expectation-defying twist in its mere pilot episode. The bulk of the pilot paints it as a pretty familiar police procedural focused on the operations of corrupt detective Vic Mackey and his close-knit strike team of similarly dubiously motivated officers. New LAPD Captain David Aceveda wants to clean up the force for the sake of his political career, and so has inserted a mole, Terry Crowley, into the outfit in the hope of exposing the strike team's corrupt activities. However, at the end of the episode, when the team raids a drug dealer's apartment, Mackey grabs the dealer's gun and shoots Terry in the face with it, killing him. Mackey evidently knew what Crowley was up to and took action to protect the team. This immediately cemented Vic as one of TV's all-time most fascinating anti-heroes, very light on the hero, whose increasingly indefensible actions throughout the show led to one of the most satisfying series finales in the history of the medium. Number 4. Nina is the Mole and Killed Terry Bauer in 24. 24's first season was a thrilling emotional rollercoaster which concluded with a double whammy of jaw-dropping plot twists. First and foremost, we found out at the end of the season that the mole undermining CTU the whole time was none other than Jack Bauer's colleague and former lover, Nina Myers. This proved especially shocking given that the prospect of Nina being the mole was raised and persuasively dismissed earlier in the season. For the show to loop back around and reveal that Nina was indeed the mole hiding in plain sight was quite the ingenious double swerve. Secondly, after Nina is captured, we learn of her brutal final act before being taken into custody, killing Jack's estranged wife, Terry, who, to somehow make matters worse, was also pregnant with their child. Given that the audiences of 2001 were absolutely expecting a happy ending to Bauer's hellish day, this was an absolute gut punch. There was no catharsis whatsoever as Jack cradled his late wife's corpse and the season signed off with a silent clock, as would become a series staple reserved for only the most meaningful of character deaths. Number 3. Omar gets killed by a child in The Wire. Robin Hood-esque stick-up man Omar Little was undeniably one of The Wire's coolest and most popular characters. A seemingly untouchable folk figure of Baltimore who made a living ripping off street-level drug dealers while abhorring the idea of civilian collateral damage. At the same time, no mere man is truly indestructible, and so the show's fifth season finale saw Omar meet his match, yet ironically not at the hands of the police or a well-minted drug kingpin, but a mere child. In one of the show's last few episodes' clarifications, Omar enters a convenience store and is promptly shot in the head by a young boy, Kennard. It seemed like the most unlikely of fates for Omar, and even quite anticlimactic, and yet totally apt in its own way. The only person capable of getting close enough to Omar to put his lights out was a harmless-looking boy. Nevertheless, the final episodes make it clear that Omar's death quickly became mythologized around Baltimore as a shootout with either the police or a gang, because the notion of him being killed by a child felt so much stranger than fiction. Number 2. They're actually in the bad place, in the good place. The Good Place's kooky setup involves Eleanor Shellstrop dying and ending up in the seemingly idyllic titular afterlife. But considering she's hardly the sort of savory, utopia-worthy sort, she soon realizes that she's been sent to the Good Place by accident. It seems like a perfectly respectable setup for a few seasons worth of silly shenanigans, but creator Michael Schur violently pulls the rug out from audiences in the first season's 13th and final episode, Michael's Gambit. The episode reveals that the Good Place is actually the bad place in disguise, and the various zany mishaps were actually carried out at the behest of their overseer, Michael, who is in fact a demon tasked with torturing them. All the sitcom-worthy hijinks were really part of a bigger picture reveal, one which made revisiting the first season a real hoot given the many retrospectively blatant clues on offer. This is a classic example of a show luring the audience into a false sense of security with its frothy presentation, only to deliver something brilliantly subversive totally out of nowhere. Number 1. Tony's ambiguous fate in The Sopranos. Everyone and their uncle had an idea about how The Sopranos would end. Typically either death, prison, or inexplicable salvation for mobster Tony Soprano. But in the show's contentious final episode, creator David Chase delivered the mesmerizing troll to rule them all. The Sopranos' closing scene is basically the Schrödinger's cat of series finales, ending on an intentionally incomplete and ambiguous note that completely denies the audience catharsis or closure. As Tony sits in a diner with his family, someone enters the diner. We see Tony look up, and then the scene and the show abruptly cuts to black. The end. At first, many viewers watching live assumed that their cable signal had cut out, but in fact, Chase made the bold decision to deny fans the ultimate answer they were expecting. Not a single person watching could have conceived that Tony's story would end this way, and fans continue to debate Tony's survival or not to this very day. Chase himself has gone back and forth on Tony's fate over the years, but mostly seems unwilling to provide a concrete answer, as is probably for the best. Leaving things up in the air keeps Tony weirdly alive in a way, and at the same time, not, alas, Schrödinger's cat. And that concludes our list. If you can think of any other examples, then do let us know in the comments below. And while you're there, don't forget to like and subscribe and tap that notification bell. Also, head over to Twitter and follow us there, and I can be found across various social medias just by searching Ellie Littlechild. I've been Ellie with What Culture. I hope you have a magical day, and I'll see you real soon.